Hey you, and welcome. In this whole video, I'm going to be going over how to reset a Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10, or even a Windows 11 password without knowing the password first. Now, if you're a subscriber and you watch a lot of my videos, you notice that I just finished a video last week talking about the same thing. Well, in the previous video, I talked about how to reset or remove a Windows password using an app called PassFab for WinKey. This time, I'm going to be showing you how to do it without using that app. However, you are going to need to download the Windows Media Creation tool and be able to get into the command line and key in some commands. Now, the way I'm going to show you is the way that we do it in my classroom, and normally my students take about 30 to 40 minutes to actually do all the steps from beginning to end. And at the end, they have a computer with a password that's been changed to the one that they've decided to go with. Now, in the lesson that we're going to be doing today, we're going to change a password that we don't know the password is. We don't know what it is, but we're going to change it to being 12345. And basically, it's going to be requiring us to actually alter something, a very important Windows file, and then changing it back. All right, so we're going to be doing a little bit of changing of files basically in Windows, but we won't be losing any data. Now again, if you're shy about working within the command line, if you don't want to type in commands, then watch the other video. And that one has a app that you can download, and it basically does everything for you, but it's not free. All right, so let's go into how to reset a Windows password step by step. Here I am in my lesson. Now what we're going to do is we're going to turn on the PC, and then step one there is we'll boot up from the Windows installation CD or a Windows boot drive. Now this can be found within the Media Creation tool, and that's found, I'll put a link to that in the description for you here. But let's go ahead and actually click on that link right now and show you what it looks like. So here's the, at Microsoft.com, they have what's called a Create Installation Media for Windows. And at this window, you notice that you have Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10. That would include something for like Windows 11 as well. And you simply click on your operating system. So if you have 7, click on 7. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click on Windows 10. And here we are at this window now. And on this, you notice it says download tool now. So all I need to do is click on download the tool, and I'll click that right now so we can actually see it. There it is. It's called the Media Creation tool, and we're using 21H1, but as time goes on, they change those last numbers there because that's the version number. And that's an .exe file. It'll get downloaded to your downloads folder in your Windows machine, and then you'll put a spare or a blank thumb drive or pen drive into your USB port, and then run this tool, and basically it'll format and create a bootable disk from one of these pen drives. Click on save to save it. And you can see at the bottom of my screen there, it says Media Creation Tool. And so it's saved there. Now, you can actually access it right there on the screen, or go into your downloads folder and access it there. Okay, now I'm gonna go back to the lesson. So by this step, you should have created the boot media. And now, what we're gonna be doing is, as soon as you turn on your PC, you'll press either the delete, F12 or F2 key to enter what's called the boot order menu screen. Now most computers or most PCs, right when you turn them on, as you see I'm doing here, you'll notice they'll have a little message on it talking about the boot screen or the boot menu, and it'll say a letter or a command such as press the F2 or press the F12, whatever it is. Go ahead and press that function key, and it'll open up that menu. Now once that menu opens, as you see here, then you'll need to change it to the USB to be the very first one to boot from. After that, save it, and then you'll restart your PC. It will then boot either from the CD or from the USB drive, and it should do that pretty much instantly. When the computer boots up from the CD or from the USB, you should click Repair Your Computer option. Then choose Command Prompt from the various options which are shown. Step 3. Recover Windows 7 or 10 password with commands. So that's the next step here. Now for step 3-1, at the DOS prompt, type in the command that's shown here. I'll have that copied down in the description as well, so you can have it and copy it to the place that you need to. But make sure it's exactly the way it's shown there. Next step, 3-2, type the next command that you see there. And then step 3-3, you'll exit the installation, either CD or the boot, and then reboot your PC. Of course, you can remove the USB drive. Now for step number 4, we're actually going to be, in this step, we're going to be resetting the Windows 7, Windows 8, or Windows 10 password. While a Windows login screen appears, press the Shift key 5 times to bring up the command line interface. Now type in this command, which is netuser and then your name or the name of the user, and then the new password. Now in this case, we're going to be using 12345 as the new password. And so for example, the netuser could be SunShare, and then 12345, that's the password. So it's going to look just like that. And that means the password of account name SunShare is now set to 12345. Pay close attention as you're typing in the keys for that password, because if you put in something else, you've just changed it to that other thing, and we'll have to redo all the steps. So that's why I say make it easy, make it 12345 as shown here, that way you know what it is. Next, password reset work has finished so far, but the sethc.exe has been altered by what we did at the beginning of the lesson. So what we're going to need to do is actually change that back. So now use the command in the command line there, C:\, so I have it written right there for us, and I'll have that again copied like all the others down in the description, and you'll type that in and then hit the enter key. What this will do is this will restore the original sethc file so that it can't be your password won't be changed again there. So you can actually go back and do these steps. It usually takes my class between 30 and 40 minutes to do their computers and change their passwords in this way. But what's nice about it is you don't have to buy any programs or apps to do this. You're doing this on your own. Just a little quick disclaimer here. Make sure you do the commands exactly the way they're shown here, because if you do something like add extra spaces or don't put in spaces, then guess what? It won't work for you. So that's why I have these steps written for you here, but I also have my other video which just uses that app. Again, that app, you have to buy it or pay for it, but it does change your password or even remove your Windows password, and it does it really quick, in the matter of just a few minutes there. So there you go, now you know 2 different ways to reset a password on a Windows computer. One is by using that app that I shown there at the beginning, and the other way is by using those commands and also the Windows Media Creation Tool from Microsoft. If you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below, because I love to read your comments. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you, everyone. I really appreciate all of the comments, actually, that you've been giving in the last few months there, and to all the videos. It's wonderful. I do try to read every single one of them and actually reply to all of them. And I also appreciate all of the help that you've basically given to the work that I do through the PayPal. So I do in my channel, I have a quick PayPal link. So if you go to my YouTube channel, there on the front page, you'll see a little link that says PayPal. And that's for you. If you want to, you can give a quick donation there of a couple dollars, buy me some coffee one day. And I really appreciate it. I just wanted to say thank you to all those who have actually done that and bought me coffee there in the last few weeks. That is awesome. All right. Thank you again, everyone. You have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.